agility and the cost of change. Now I'll show you how this agile development can change or can cut the cost as compared to the trivial and traditional kind of SDLCs or software development life cycles. The main thing is change. Agility, agile development is all about welcoming the change, doing the change at the later stages. Now you see there are three lines. You have to first see the dark black curve. The x-axis is showing the development schedule progress and the y-axis is development cost. Here the cost of change increases non-linearly, that is, it is not a straight line, as the project is progressing. That is, the point where you would like to do the change, the cost will be higher. That is, if you want to change here, just make a line parallel to x-axis, here will be the development cost. So at the later stages, if the change is suggested, the cost will be higher in the traditional waterfall models, spiral models, or the prescriptive models. Okay, so it is easy to accommodate when the requirement phase is there, easy, early in the stages of the project. But you know, when the user comes, because in at previous stages you can even change the requirements, and you know, because the design has not been made, the modeling has not been done, the coding has not been done. But the requirement, the design, it will be difficult if the change is at the later stage. But if someone comes at the later stage, it is very difficult for you to cut the cost and keep the schedule, because it will adversely affect it. But what if an important stakeholder comes and he says, say at the later stages, at the develop, after design has done, UDP are doing, please do it on TCP, transmission control protocol I want. What will you do? That is, the architectural design has been made, the construction already has been done, the component has been done. So you have to change the component design, you have to modify the architectural design, even you have to design new test. If the change is prescribed to you by the user at the later stages, so the time and cost, it will affect your project. It will affect the cost. It will affect the schedule. It is going to happen if the changes are done or prescribed to you, or you do it at the later stages when you use a conventional kind of software development lifecycle. Now let me tell you about the agile. This is the blue line you are seeing. Actually, it has to be at this dotted line, but it is very difficult to achieve this. But the agile development, if you make a well-designed agile process, you know, this curve, which was earlier because of the prescriptive kind of models, it was like this, because the later stages change will adversely affect the time and cost. Now, because of the well-designed agile process, the cost can be reduced, because the software team can now accommodate, now can change at the later stages. There will be no adverse or dramatic cost and time impact. How do they do it? Because this, you have to provide the agility and how to get it. Because if you see here, same point, if we change the traditional and the agile, they both have different cost. So agile process, do it by incremental delivery. That is, make an operational software, give it to the user. Then add some more functionality, and depending upon the feedback, you give them incremental delivery. Every time there has to be unit testing, continuous unit testing, and the pair programming, the fast delivery. The pair programming is all about two people sitting together while development is done. That is, one will develop, other will be doing the quality assurance, and other, you know, they both can change their action. And because of this, the cost can be attenuated, or you can say cut down. So this is how the agility works.